Good evening. I will be making the first presentation and sharing this session. And as you know, we are late. So I will ask my other colleagues that are part from Janus to be close to the podium to be ready to make the presentation. So I'm Blanca Jimenez from Mexico, and I was the past co-chair of the water program. Now the current chair is Catherine Vamen, and I've been asked to talk to give a big picture on the which is the water situation around the world and notably in Latin America. And at the end, I will talk as a conclusion on a small slide that is very related to this past presentation. Okay, which is the challenge of this 21st century? We are talking about water security. And by the way, water security and all these terms of energy security, food security, is a concept that was coined by the program I am currently chairing, I'm secretary, the International Hydrological Program. And it's a very interesting concept that helps to communicate. The definition is a different thing, but it helps to communicate. 85% of the human population live in arid areas, and by 2030, half of the population will be living under water stress conditions. 6 to 8 million human beings are killed each year from water-related disasters and diseases. 700 million people lack access to safe water and 2.5 billion to adequate sanitation. In the first item, we are talking about, water resources, and the second about water services. Also, at least 85% of the world's total wastewater that is discharged without treatment, and this is causing severe pollution problems. And just as an indicator, in 30 years, 50% of the populations of freshwater species have declined. And the news for this century, and I'm calling this the challenge of this century, is that we are learning, all of us now, that we are sharing waters. There are 145 nations that have transboundary rivers. And in just 3 or 4 years, the amount of aquifers that have been detected that are transboundary have increased from 200 to nearly 600. And that means that we will need to learn how to share this water and how to manage it better. For all these reasons, it is estimated that 80% of the population is it's facing different levels of threats of water security. And this is a very interesting problem. And we know that it's caused by no climatic changes that are related to socioeconomic development, to the population growth, to the consumption patterns, but as well to land use, to the changes on land use and the land cover changes, to the way in which we are using water for different purposes, agricultural, municipal, or industrial uses. But what we have heard more recently is that we have, in addition, the problems of climate change. And many people think that the main problem with water will be caused by the impacts of climate change because of the changes or the modifications on precipitation, temperature, and all the associated problems such as glacier melting or sea level rise. Why? Because it is estimated that 80% of the cost of adaptation are related to water problems. So somehow people think that that's the main problem. But guess what? No, in IPCC, I was co-leading the chair for adaptation. I was the co-chair for the chapter for adaptation on water resources. And even even though this figure is true, by far Non-climatic changes are the major sources of problems for all hydrological changes we are experiencing. And that means that we have been doing something wrong that is not associated to climate change, and we really need to change, to modify the way in which we are managing water. Some of the major aspects in which science should be involved is in addressing risk, managing climatic and non-climatic water-related risk, but as well we need to adapt to the modifications of the water cycles that we have made, but also start to learn how to control the modifications of the water cycle that have been made by anthropogenic causes. Concerning water resources, it's important to perform restoration, to protect water resources, but also to sustainably manage them. To work on transboundary water, as I said, this will be an issue, to better understand water, food, and energy security nexus. Water is connected to many other big, and health is missing in here as well. And that means for the scientists that we need to work outside the sectors and we need to work for other sectors. And that's very different for scientists because we are normally, we only work for ourselves and we don't like to work with the others. So we need to work more with the others. And for water services, we need to balance better the availability of water with water demand in temporal terms, but also applying equity and ethical principles. We also need to implement efficient and reliable water services at a fair and accessible cost. And that is meaning that we really need to work transdisciplinary. It's not only, we need to involve more social and economic science. And we need to produce new type of students that and professionals that work integrally addressing the problems and do not have these different compartments in mind. The efficient use of water is another issue. We need to use less water per activity. We need to reuse and recycling. Water is green. It's very interesting that people very easily adopted to recycle solid wastes, but to recycle water, people don't accept that as easy. So that is also, that has to do with the preconceptions that we have from the past. Also, we need to use water when really needed. I don't know why, but we have a tendency to use water for everything. And there are many, many things for what we don't use, we don't need to use water. There are now dry shampoos, we can wash cars without using water. All these things are now in there, available to be used. We need to prepare the future. We need to have new conceptions for cities. And also we need to think, even in the broader pictures, do we really need to live in these big cities and big urban areas? It's unsustainable. Cities are a very, very tiny small of area in which we are demanding a lot of water, food, and energy, and then we're discharging a lot of pollutants. This is not sustainable, so we really need to rethink the way in which we're doing this. We have to ensure that we have water for all the uses, but as well for ecosystem services, and to work on removing different barriers for adaptation, to develop human institutional capacity, finance mechanisms, also raising capacities and communications. And there are many scientists that say, well, we don't do that, this is not science. But I think we will need to do that, and there is also science involved in there. Why we need to do that? This is the program in which I'm the secretary at UNESCO, but which is interesting here. This program that is being developed by the member states of UNESCO have been in place for 50 years. And the situation of water is going worse. We are not solving the problem. So something, we're doing something wrong. But also, have a look on what what people were doing. Of course, I was not around at this time. But when the program started, first was only about gathering data. And that has to do with many of the things that are happening in other fields of sciences. First was about gathering data. Then people start to understand that we need to have international cooperations to cooperate between different, with all the science scientists in the world. The academy, the president of the next president of the Academy of Science was saying that United States can use science from other parts of the world. Well, that was an idea that was in this period of time. Then it was about the sustainable development. It's the 90s, in the 90s. Then there was the politicians and the policymakers understood that we need to take care of the environment. It's 1996. In 2002, they start to say, hey, we need more social science. We are not solving the problem. So social science came along. Then it was, we need to start responding to the different dependencies, all these nexus, talking about the nexus about water started in this state, in this period of time. And now we're talking about water security. And we're talking about water security, food security. And the message behind that is that we are a threat, not only because of water, but for many other issues. And we are now need to face global changes. And for that, we need to have global scientists, global science, and global solutions, which are very difficult to be implemented. I'm going to go very quickly through Latin America. Latin America has one-third of the world water resources. Nevertheless, there are 142 million people that live in water scarce areas. We have water, but water is not where people is, and this is a common situation, but that's the way it is. Also, water is very important for agriculture, and Latin America is also exporting a lot of virtual water. Virtual water is the water that goes through the, that has been used to produce something that is exported. But many countries have that as a policy. Instead of using my water, instead for using my water to produce avocados, I prefer to buy the avocados from Mexico because they will be using their water while I'm preserving my water. But also water is associated with many products. We need it to produce the crude oil, to produce the cars. These are the main products of exportations in from Latin America and for mining. Concerning water services, I don't know if today or, yes, it was today, it was mentioned that the United Nations, on the, I think 5 or 6 years ago, made an international call saying that for the year 2030, we will be 60% of people living in cities. And was like, oh, that's we need to do something. We cannot live that way. But guess what? Latin America is at 82% of urbanization. Most of the people in Latin America lives in cities. And that is a problem, and we're facing the problem of the future for many other parts of the world. So we need to live a different way on living in cities, but as well on having the water services. Most of the people that don't have still water services in Latin America live in slums and rural areas. 82% of the urban population, but 25% of the people living in slums. So we have there a big challenge. Just related to sanitation, 20% of the municipal water that is recovered in sewers is treated. And to cover sanitation, we need around $250 to $300 per capita, which is a lot. And water-related diseases are still very important. those that live in cities, and this is a problem that for those that live in America will understand very quickly. Most of the people, not all the people that live in cities are connected to the network, so and the difference is very significant from one city to another city in Latin America, and there are a lot of people receiving water through water tanks. Because those that are connected to the network, we don't have enough pressure in the network. That's why we have also water tanks above the houses. Still many people from other countries do not realize this problem. Because there is not enough pressure in the network, the water that is received, even if it is treated properly at the at a drinking water plant, when it reaches home, is not properly, is not potable, and because it's not at constant pressure, it has cycles of vacuum and pressures, and we have a very high amount of leaks. At least 45% of the water that is provided to the cities is lost, and this is representing a very high cost. We have also problems of floods and droughts. 1 million of people are affected by floods. 1.7 are affected by droughts. By the way, droughts are much more impacting much more the population in terms of cost than floods, at least 5 to 10 times more. The issue is that floods do not look very well in the journals, in the news, while the floods are impress a lot of people. So we not know much more less from well, the normal people know much more less from the impacts of droughts than floods. And the frequency is increasing in very disproportionate way. And having a cost of $15 billion dollars in Latin America. All this represents, all water problems represents a cost of 4% of the gross national project. Can you please click on just have a look at this. This is a leak of water. Most of the people do not realize you don't see water leaks and you are losing water. You are losing energy, because to have the water in there to be lost, there is a cost of energy and the cost to treat this water. So we are losing a lot of infrastructure. In some cases, even there are big holes in the streets that we don't realize because the pavement remains there until a car goes there and it simply sinks on these holes. In Mexico, there has been a case where a car went to the hole, and the person died there because of these holes. And this is my last slide, which I was listening very careful to the last presentation, which was about education, because this, what has been said in the past presentation, also applies for policymakers. We have been 50 years working on a lot of issues on water. The solutions are not there. We know what to do in many cases, but simply we don't manage to pass the message. Why? Because here we are the scientists. We are all working isolated in our different disciplines. Each of us is one isolated dot. We produce information, but for policymakers, information that we produce is like listening to Chinese. They really don't understand what we are saying. We have the academies of science that more or less arrange the information, and there is still need for a policy science interface that put all this information in a more logic manner, in a message that is understandable by policymakers that can fix the problem. Either we do this interface, either other people can do it, but we will have to pay a price. Because if we don't start communicating in a better way, those that will be doing the communicated for us can convey their own messages. So it's very important to work differently. So in summary, water security is at risk because of climatic challenges, but not climatic ones, and these are the major stressors. Water is a transboundary issues, and they can be source of international conflicts. We will need even to produce new legal frameworks. But before that, we need to better understand how transboundary water works. Latin America has challenges related to water resources, but as well concerning water services, and for this, solutions are available. The problem is not a technical one. The problem it's more economic, financial, social, and still there is a lot of contributions that science can be doing in this. Scientists from Latin America, we need to contribute to shape new concepts for future human settlements concerning water, food, energy. Water is a renewable resource, but it has to be used when needed at a reasonable quantity and to be returned to the environment with an adequate quality for other users and users, including the environment. And scientists need to better communicate with policymakers. And we can use intermediates or not, but when communicating, and it's what the previous speaker was saying, we need to provide the data that the policy makes needed, but also meaningful messages for them. We provide information by disciplines, and this is not helping to solve the solutions. We need to give the entire picture. And with that, I hope I only took 15 minutes. I don't know who was taking me there. And thank you very much.